All right, so 1 o'clock in the morning, March the 18th, and I'm going to show you a little something here I've been trying to do, I've been thinking about doing for a long time to show you what's going on with this old lathe. This is a Jet 1240 PD, model 1240 PD. It was originally made in Taiwan. I got a hell of a deal on it. Essentially, it was free because the mill, I bought the mill new. If I bought it new, it would have been $2,300. And this came with it. A guy named West had it, an old man, had a machine shop. And he had to go to a nursing home, and he had a lathe and a mill in his garage, one car garage, and put it in the paper for sale. I went over there, picked it up. I guess I was the only one that went there. He gave me all his material, gave me the lathe and the mill, everything for, I guess he couldn't even add, he was so old. Got the whole thing, got the whole deal for $2,300. Paid a friend of mine with a truck and a forklift to bring it to the house, put it in the garage. I think I paid him, I don't know, $200 cash, whatever. But anyway, the reason the lathe was, you couldn't test the lathe, he already had it disconnected. So when we got it, I had a little problem with it. It didn't even have a motor for the coolant pump. Let me go to close up. This is the compound right here. You see that brass looking stuff? That's brazing. And what that means is somebody broke it and then brazed it back together. That's made of cast iron. You see how that works like that? Well, if your machine breaks, you braze it back together, you got to go in there and remachine it. And that's a gob job right there. So it worked for a little while, and then it broke because this side wasn't supported by the base, and so it broke. And what we have over here now, there's my indicator, and it keeps the tool out of the chuck. You keep the tool out of the chuck, it won't collide with the chuck, and it won't break your compound. You see how pretty that is? You know why that's pretty? I made it. The other reason why it's pretty is Yogi Jr., after I made it, took it and had it parallel ground while he was still in high school as a senior. That was 3 years ago. Going on 3 years. Okay? Well, the reason that's on there is because obviously, that broke. I'm going to switch this back to long range. I love this camera, by the way. So when that broke, it was, you know, a cluster. This right here, this material, you know, you can't find material like this because of the size of it. You know, it's just not going it's not on the shelf. If it was on the shelf, it'd be 20 feet long. So I called around and I found a piece of scrap metal that was approximately 2.5 times the size of what I needed. And I got it for free because it was somebody's paperweight, or they were holding the door open with it, and mild steel, and it was flame cut. So I had to go down it. I'll switch this to close-up so you can see it even better. All these marks in it are from the mill cutting it to size, okay? This is a raw piece. Fly cutter. But anyway, it was 2.5 times the size. I knocked it down with the mill. and I had to weld a piece of metal onto it and put it in the bandsaw, standing straight up like that. And I had to babysit that bandsaw for 3 hours while it cut through that piece of metal to make sure it didn't warp or get off sides. The bandsaw blade's only 35 thousandths wide. It cuts about a 37 thousandths wide slot, but it has to be perfectly parallel. Then you come back, once you get that done, once you get the piece cut off, cut in half, and it had to cut it on the long side here. It wasn't on the short side. It's on the long side. So it was a pain in the ass, okay? You can't imagine. Well, maybe you can. I don't know. So then you have to take all the dimensions off the original part. And don't think I didn't try to buy a new one. But they don't make them like this anymore because they switched from Taiwan to China. And so all the dimensions are different. It's all different now. There's a big cavity in here. Well, if you're starting with a solid block, you have to mill out all the way down into the bottom here. And it's probably a quarter inch. You have to mill that whole slot out for the screw. Then you need a dovetail cutter to cut the dovetail. Can you see that? Run along there. This little viewfinder isn't worth a crap. So you gotta cut the dovetail gently along both sides. Okay? You can't just dive into it with a whole depth and cut it. That's just not gonna work. On the other side, you have a T-slot. So for that, you're gonna need Woodruff key cutter, whatever you can get, and go through there and make sure that your depth on both sides is right, and you know the deal. I mean, it's not rocket science. But before you even put that in there, you have to mill this whole slot just to get it in there. Okay, you're talking days worth of machining. There's a little hole that's threaded. Whoopie-doo. So, I had to make the whole damn thing out of mild steel, not cast iron. And then, center the holes in here, these threaded holes, that's for the screw. This is what you come out with. Back in business. Because you cannot buy the part. Let's look at that slot. Let's look at that T-slot. That's how it's set up. I wanted to make the whole base that it goes on, but I didn't have a piece of round material big enough to do that. So anyway, when your old crap breaks, you gotta make parts to fix it. I've never made one of these parts before in my life, but that one is perfect. Never had a Woodruff key cutter or a key cutter or any kind of cutter in my inventory. eBay. Never had a dovetail cutter in my life. Had to make it. Well, had to buy that and had to make the part. And Yogi Jr. took it to the parallel grinder and cleaned it all up for us. And it works better than original because it's stronger than original. It's not cast iron. It's mild steel. It doesn't move very much, so you don't have to worry about that. There's the junk from Taiwan. It's even worse now from China. And have a whole new one. Oh, by the way, it's $1,600. The lathe, if you bought the lathe new, it's $8,000 some. You know, plus freight, etc., whatever. $8,000, $9,000 by the time you're done. I got it for free. All I had to do is fix it. And I can make a whole new one of these because I have the old one. The only other thing wrong with the lathe was the lock on it. It's way down in here in the middle of the mess. See that piece of brass? Made it out of brass this time instead of steel. That way it won't mar the bottom of the way when I clamp it. It's 3/8 inch bolt holding it in. Yeah, this is fun. You can't beat it. Free lathe, all you gotta do is fix it. Bye.